The story of Tiffany Stasi, also known as Heather Tiffany Robinson, is a roller coaster of trauma. From murder and kidnapping to an identity crisis and search for justice, the situation is filled with compelling yet shocking twists and turns. In 1984, a 19-year-old woman named Lisa Stasi gave birth to a healthy little girl that she named Tiffany Stasi. Unfortunately, Lisa was trapped in an abusive marriage with her child's father. She took the abuse and struggled to better her life for 4 months after Tiffany was born. After that, though, she decided enough was enough, and she fled from her marriage. She moved to a shelter for abused and battered women with children in Kansas City, Kansas, around 1985. After living in the shelter and struggling as a single mom for quite some time, Lisa met someone she thought would turn her life around and help her find solid ground, named John Osborne. There aren't any details explaining how the pair met, but apparently John started making promises to Lisa and her daughter Tiffany. He offered to help them move to Chicago, where Lisa could get a better job. He promised free daycare for her child and occasional money from his own pocket to help them get by. The string of promises stretched, and Lisa was mostly convinced. John took her and the baby to a motel so they could spend a night or two away from the chaos and filth of the shelter that they were in. Lisa, her daughter, and John stayed at the motel for an unknown period of time, and while there, John gave Lisa an ultimatum that made the overall situation questionable. He informed her that he would only provide the help he offered if Lisa signed a stack of blank stationery paper. He refused to explain why exactly he needed this, but tried to convince Lisa that it was harmless and he had no ulterior motives. Lisa hesitated, and John became angry. While he was out of the room, Lisa called her aunt in tears and hysteria, trying to explain the signature situation. While Lisa knew signing the paper was a bad idea, she was desperate for the help being promised. Her aunt urged her not to sign anything and to instead find a way to her aunt's home, and she could live there safely. The call ended, and that was the last time that anyone heard from Lisa Stasi. Lisa's aunt contacted Kansas City law enforcement a few days after the call. She explained that she hadn't heard from Lisa since and was worried that she got herself involved with a dangerous man or situation. She told them about John Osborne and encouraged them to start their search with him. A search followed, and they did as instructed by first investigating the stranger known as John Osborne. They found that his name had been used at the motel and confirmed the mother and daughter had been there as well. Unfortunately, there was no evidence or surveillance footage to aid them in their investigation. Furthermore, they discovered that John Osborne was a fake name. Sadly, their investigation failed to prove information that would lead them to the mother or infant. They pushed forward for a few months, but eventually had to let the case go cold by assuming the pair was no longer alive. A few days after Lisa made the phone call to her aunt, while a search was ongoing for John Osborne, who is actually named John Edward Robinson, made a call to his brother and sister-in-law from an unknown location a short distance from their home. He told them that he had found a baby and asked if they were interested in adoption. Apparently, the couple had been struggling for quite some time to conceive their own child, with no success. They were overjoyed when John made this offer. He told them that the baby belonged to a woman that took her own life after giving the child to him with signed documents. He explained that they would have to pay him $5,500 in cash for adoption and legal fees. Although there was a sting of subtle doubt, the couple agreed and provided the sum of money. As promised, John arrived while later with the baby in his arms. He handed her to Donald and Helen Robinson, along with a heavy stack of paperwork. At the time, John claimed the forms came from a legitimate adoption agency that sped the process along for Don and Helen. It was later confirmed that John had actually fabricated the paperwork and forged the signatures of two lawyers and a judge to make the adoption seem real. As for the money, it was pretty obvious that he stuck it in his own pocket. The baby was in fact Tiffany Stasi, and the couple changed her name to Heather Robinson. Heather was raised by her loving parents in what she described as a happy, healthy, loving, and supported family environment. She had no idea that she was adopted, and while she later claimed she always had an uneasy feeling around her, she also had no idea that her Uncle John would turn out to be the serial killer that took his mother's life. That is, until the year 2000. John Edward Robinson was arrested for assault and battery in 2000. He was taken to the station, and officers were sent to his home address. When being charged for a felony, it was required that the residence of the suspect be inspected for evidence of any additional crimes. The officers on duty for this task probably weren't expecting what they found. At John's home, officers discovered two large barrels in the backyard. Out of curiosity and protocol, they pried both barrels open and were overwhelmed with terror and disgust. Inside the containers were the bodies of two women found decaying. The bodies were immediately picked up by a coroner after the scene was secured. A pair of additional officers went to a local storage company where John had been renting a unit for several years. Upon entering that unit, officers found another pair of barrels and assumed what was inside. Their theories were correct. Two additional women in similar conditions were found and retrieved for investigation. When the family heard the news, they were obviously in a sense of shock. Don and Helen were especially surprised to find that the relative was responsible for such heinous acts. Tiffany, then known as Heather, felt quite different about the situation. As she spent years growing up next to the serial killer, she'd picked up on some red flags and warning signs that made her feel uneasy, and confirmed her idea that her uncle was in some way abnormal. Just as John's dirty laundry was being aired, a young 16-year-old Tiffany was unraveling the details of her own past. As a result of recent discoveries, Donald and Helen Robinson decided to come clean about a few secrets they'd been hiding. They told Tiffany that she was adopted after her birth mother, who was 19 at the time, allegedly committed suicide, but that they were no longer sure if that was the truth considering the recent findings. Tiffany took the news well, but had a gut feeling that her mother had not taken her own life. John later confessed to clear the air. He claimed he was responsible for the death of Lisa Stasi and had given the infant daughter to his brother. Tiffany and her parents had a DNA test done to confirm what was now obvious. The DNA test came back and officially confirmed that Tiffany was Lisa's daughter. He shared no information about the exact fate of Lisa or where to find her remains. Tiffany chose to stay with the parents she knew and loved, despite the conditions of her adoption and their relationship to John. At the end of the day, they'd given her a good life and loved her deeply, which was all she cared about. Although it's still concerning to consider that Tiffany grew up in the shadow of a serial killer that took her own mother's life. It's a miracle that John never hurt the child and that she was put into a good family. Because Tiffany clearly picked up on signs that John was dangerous, she could have easily turned out to be violent or demented herself. It's so easy to ruin the mind of a child, but thankfully, Tiffany grew up just fine thanks to her parents and their support. As a teen, she chose not to ignite a relationship with her biological father and didn't bother searching for him. She did, however, immediately begin digging for the truth surrounding her biological mother's passing, something that she still does to this very day. John was eventually sentenced to death over his numerous crimes, and as of now, he's had an estimated list of 8 victims, but some cases couldn't be confirmed. Similarly, some cases lacked evidence or a body like Lisa's case. Regardless, he was charged for her and 3 other deaths. Lisa's body has still not been found, and we may never know exactly what happened to her. Tiffany has spent much of her life wondering about her mother and praying she will someday be able to bring her to an empty grave marked by her name to give her spirit peace. Today, Tiffany is about 35 years old, and she has a family of her own, including a loving, devoted husband and children that all support her in her measures to find her mother and help others in similar situations. She explained during an interview with 2020 that becoming a mother inspired her to work even harder at finding her own mom. In addition to giving her mom peace, she wants to know what Lisa was actually like. Tiffany had searched for family and friends that may have known Lisa, but she hasn't had the best of luck. As she's gotten older, she's also grown an interest in communicating with her biological father, even if it's just to learn more about Lisa. Tiffany remains pretty open about her life story and her mission. She operates a Facebook group known as the Lisa Stasi Effect. In this group, she frequently posts memes and fun content. She says that she does this to offer members in similar situations a place to laugh and be less serious. That isn't all she does, though. She also uses the group to spread her campaign tag, Find Lisa Stasi, to increase awareness in the event of an unidentified woman that's found somewhere that could be her mother. She allows members to discuss their own issues and spread their own awareness of cases. Tiffany even occasionally discusses what it's like to grow up around a serial killer and how it impacted her life. One result of her tragic situation is that she commonly brings to light that she's developed PTSD, which is a common mental illness that causes anxiety, depression, and so much more. PTSD can remain undiagnosed in some people, and Tiffany explained that sharing memes, resources, and general content on the subject could potentially help an online user discover their illness and seek professional help. Tiffany's life had a rough start, there's no doubt in that. And at the age of 16, she was forced to face dark truths about her uncle, her mother, and herself. Most people can't even imagine what Tiffany must have gone through mentally after being shown the truth, and it's easy to assume that someone in her position would go on to fail in life due to trauma and stress. Tiffany proved those theories wrong when she picked up her head, carried on with her life, found her own happiness, and began working to help others. Hopefully, Tiffany continues to lead a happy life, and maybe someday she'll finally find her mother and fully put the past behind her.